Hello everyone and welcome to the Frontend Crash Course. In the previous lecture, we've learned how to use view props to send data from a parent component to a child component. But what if we want to send data from a child component up to the parent? Well, in that case, we use view emit. To demonstrate how to use it, I'm going to add a button to allow logout user. In the user info component, let's add a divider to separate the info section from the button. Make sure that this divider component is imported from PrimeView. Since it doesn't contain any element inside, we can combine the open and close tags into one tag like this. Now save the file and check the UI. We see a horizontal line appears under the email. Next, I'm going to add a button right below the divider. Again, make sure it is imported from PrimeView. Then we will set a label for this button to be logout and also add an icon to it. For now, the button is completely empty. Let's search for a suitable icon in the PrimeView documentation page. I'm going to use a pi signout icon. So let's copy and paste it to our code. Save the file and check the browser again. This time, the button is nicely displayed with the icon and the logout label. So the look of the button is okay, but it doesn't have any action associated yet. Now we have to define a function in the script section to handle the click event. Before doing that, let me remind you that the authenticated user is passed to this user info component by the home view, where we actually get the user object from the store.state. And in that store, we have a function to clear the user and the tokens. That will be the function we want to call when the logout button is clicked. Now, although it's possible to call that function directly inside the user info component, I want to show you how to emit event to the parent component. So here, let's declare a constant emit using the define emit keyword. Inside this bracket, we'll define the function signature of the emit, which will accept the first string argument logout and the second argument of type user, and will return nothing. We must strictly follow this function signature when we emit the event. So here in the onLogout function, I'm going to call emit logout and pass in props.user as a second argument. If your components have multiple events to emit, you can list them all here. Alright, now let's add the click event to the logout button and bind it to the onLogout function we've just written. Okay, so now, whenever the logout button is clicked, the onLogout function will be called, which in turn emits a logout event to the parent of this component. So let's go to the home view component and handle that event. Here in the user info tag, we can use @logout to register a handler function for the logout event. Let's declare that function in the script section. It will receive a user object as input because we emit that in the event. The most important thing to do in this function is to call store.clearUser to delete the user and the access or refresh tokens from the memory. Make sure to import the user type. Then I want to display a toast message to inform user that they have successfully logged out. So let's copy the use toast call from the login user component that we wrote in one of the previous lecture. Paste it right before the onLogout function and make sure use toast is imported. And here, after clearing the user data, we'll call toast.add, just like in the login user component. We must set the severity, summary, detail, and lifetime of the toast message. In this case, the summary should be goodbye user.fullname, and the detail will be you have successfully logged out. Finally, all we have to do is to bind that onLogout function to the logout event. That's it. Now let's save the code and test it on the browser. First, I'm going to log in with the tech school user. The user profile card with the logout button will show up. Now let's click logout. As you can see, we are back to the login screen, and a toast message shows up saying, Goodbye, tech school. You have successfully logged out. That's exactly what we wanted, so it worked. Before we finish, let's improve the UI a bit. Here you can see that the form is not displayed at the center of the page, but a bit to the left. To fix this, let's open the main.css file under the asset folder. In the media tag, you will find this app section with the display grid. Here we have a pair of 1FR in the grid template columns. Since 1FR represents a fraction of the available space in the grid container, these two fractions mean that the width of the app container is divided into two equal columns. So this explains why our form is displayed on the left side of the page. Let's remove this section to see if the form can be centered or not. Indeed, now the form has been moved to the center of the page. Okay, the last thing I want to do is to make this welcome message a little bit bigger. In the home view, we can see that it is written inside an H1 tag. So to change its style, I'm gonna add a style scope section and add a CSS style for the H1 tag. Let's set the font weight to 500 and the font size to 2.6 rem. Alright, now before saving the code, I'm gonna resize the window so you can see its effect immediately on the browser. As soon as I save the file, you can see that the welcome message has become bigger. Okay, so now you have it. We finally completed the authentication feature that allows user to log in, see the information, and log out. I hope you've enjoyed the lectures. Thanks a lot for watching. Happy learning, and see you in the next one.